The Challenger shuttle explosion in 1986 is a terrible experience. No other words can describe it. NASA messed up for nothing other than pride and corporate pressure. Not only did they put human lives at risk for those reasons, they lost the lives they gambled with. There are several things that NASA should have done differently. Let's look at a handful of them. But before I begin, I want to preface this by saying my observations in a few areas are rather critical. With that said, I plead ignorance as to know how the situation could have actually been different. It would be wrong not to acknowledge the literal hundreds of billions of dollars at play and the pressures that come with those financial numbers, or the extreme political pressure not just from the president and vice president for their involvement, but the pressures of racing Russia during the height of the Cold War and other reasons for these men being pressured to just get this launch moving. The whole thing is a sad part of history. With that disclosure, let's look at three things NASA could have done differently. We'll skip past the years of red flags in the shuttle design and move directly into the night before the shuttle launch. An immediate stop sign enters the road when anyone says, quote, take off your engineering hat and put on your management hat, close quote. Those words from Gerald Mason to Bob Lund should go down in history as the most arrogant and ignorant words to be expressed at a time like that. They're careless and filled with fear and intimidation leadership style that has no place. Gerald Mason, uneducated in engineering, ignorant or simply careless to the cost he is negotiating with, should have recognized his place in dealing with these lives. Certainly, demand from the organization, pressures in government, and all other outside reasons for moving forward quickly should have come second to the safety of those involved. The second point is simply this. Shame on you, Bob Lund. Succumbing to peer pressure, going against your logic, your gut, your team, your facts, and your education simply should not have happened. Number three, NASA's management and lack of inter-team and inter-department communication should absolutely be considered in what could have been done differently. Had all parties involved in the launch been apprised of the cold and its safety concerns, maybe we would have those seven astronauts alive still today. Then there's Roger Boas-Jolly. The question is posed, what should he have done differently? I believe he did all he could. Quitting or finding a new job were not only out of the question, but also irrational and irresponsible. He was there and had an obligation to see this through. I think his efforts in repeatedly trying to postpone the launch were merit enough to suggest that there was nothing else he could do. It would have been inappropriate and insubordinate for him to do something drastic, like jump over the heads of command in his management team, let alone dangerous for him, because if the launch had been successful, he would likely have lost his job for insubordination afterwards. Ultimately, at the end of the day, I think that engineers and all involved have a responsibility to be educated enough to tackle these problems and to have the guts to stand up for what is right and properly prioritize human safety over corporate pressures. With that, I think managers in all areas need to heed to the education of their field superiors. This goes for managers at all levels. Understandably, mid-level managers, as well as executive-level administrators who are reporting to boards, are under immense pressure to produce outcomes and deliver results. But if all involved parties, including even at times the President of the United States for that matter, would take a more understanding approach, corners wouldn't have to be cut, and safety could be observed. Thank you.